Hello everyone, and welcome to the Modern Java course. The last time around, I introduced you to the Manifold project and its fantastic approach to integrating JSON natively into Java. Today, we will talk about string templates, which is a feature Java plans to integrate, but hasn't yet. With Manifold, you can get it today and go much deeper with a general purpose templating engine built into the language. But before I proceed, as usual, the code for this and other videos in this series is available on my GitHub page. So check out this project, start it, and follow me on GitHub. I will skip the project creation, but I do want to show the pom file. Notice that our code for supporting templates is very simple, just one dependency and a bit of a compiler level configuration, specifically the annotation processing path. Once we have that in order, we can jump to the code. First, I want to create a new variable that we can use to get external input. I use the args value, but since I want this to work even without an argument, I use the ternary operator to assign the value. The interesting part is the second line. Notice that as I type the $world expression, it changes its color. It's no longer a string, it's a variable embedded in a string. That means I can control click it and go to the variable declaration. That means it will rename if I refactor the variable name. It will fail to compile if I remove the variable, and it will appear when I run find usage. Notice that the backslash syntax implicitly disables this behavior, just like in other string elements in Java. Running this produces the expected result. The variable is replaced and the escape symbol remains. There's another way to escape a string. Let's say we have many strings with the dollar sign in them and don't want to risk a problem. You can use the DisableStringLiteralTemplates annotation on a method or on a class to disable this functionality in the block of code. Notice that in this case, even the IDE recognizes it. The color of the word is the same as the string, and it won't be clickable. This functionality has no runtime dependency. This is 100% compile time code, which means it's efficient and low overhead, but it has another important implication that you should consider. If you read a string or load it from somewhere and it includes the dollar symbol, that will work like it always did in Java. So you don't need to worry about any problems related to that. Under the resources templates directory, I can create a new template file, a mantle file in this case, which can be any file type. I'll pick HTML, which is pretty common for templating. And now it's just an HTML file like any other, with one major exception, the header. We can accept parameters for the template file through the parameters header. Notice this works with code completion since this is just Java code. We can then use the dollar and curly braces syntax to fill the parameters values into the HTML file we're generating. We can now access the HTML file as a class, just like we could when working with parsed JSON. We must pass in the parameters, which again are type checked by the compiler. Here I'm printing out the HTML, but we can do anything with it. Send an email, return a response to a web request, etc. This can be used with a framework like Spark to create a very minimal and efficient web application. When we run the application, we can see the HTML printed out with the right title and body. Now you might be thinking, hey, we have many templating APIs, JSP, Velocity, FreeMaker, ThymeLeaf, etc. Those are great, and this isn't meant to replace them, at least not yet. At the moment, the main use case I have for this is generating files that aren't a web application. In several cases, I wrote code generators, and while there are some interesting projects that do that, they each have their own issues. This lets me generate a Java source file by creating it in the IDE. This code lets me generate a simple Java class file right in the IDE and accept the various variables that we can use for the code generation portion. I accept only two parameters here to keep the code simple, but the gist is still the same. We can use it to generate any arbitrary file we want. I'll skip the usage and running of this since it's all most of the same. I want to discuss what this template language can do. The template language is very reminiscent of JSP, and for good reason. It compiles to a class file, but unlike JSP, it's more generic, not a servlet. As such, it has many commands we will find familiar. An import statement adds an import to the generated class, which lets the embedded code access the imported class, just like in JSP. We can define a base class to a template. This helps us create a generic code for the template and place common functionality in a single location. For this to work, we must create a class that extends the manifold runtime base templates class. Include simply includes another template into the current template. This lets us assemble sophisticated templates like headers, footers, and footers. If we want to generate a complex Java class, we can wrap the boilerplate in a generic template and include that in. We can conditionally include a template using an if statement. We can use a for loop to include multiple entries. The sky is the limit here. We covered the params statement before, so I won't go into it again, but we can mix it with an include statement to create a very useful template. This means we can pass parameters passed to us to a template and create sophisticated output. There are quite a few other sophisticated options, including layout, which seems like a great option on the surface, but at the moment it doesn't support passing parameters, so its usefulness is much reduced. Generating text in Java has been almost entirely targeted at the request response and HTML output. Those are important, but only part of the story. With Manifold, we can write fluent text processing code today without waiting for a future JVM enhancement. We can create JSP-like templates without all of the baggage. Also, if you have any questions, please use the comment section. Thank you.